Good day and welcome back. We'll talk about radioactivity. This video will include about the important definition and the formula regarding the radioactivity. We start with the definition. Basically, radioactive decay is a process where unstable nucleus become more stable by emitting radioactive radiation, which could be the alpha particle, beta particle, or gamma ray, which you have learned in STPM physics. The process is spontaneous, which means it is unpredictable. We do not know which atom will decay and when it will decay. The process is also random, where every atom has the same probability to decay. We use the term activity or rate of decay to describe about the process. It is defined as number of atoms which decay per unit time, and it is proportional to the number of radioactive nuclei in the sample. So it is not affected by any other factors, just the number of radioactive nuclei available in the sample. The formula is given as A equal to negative dN dt equal to lambda n, where the unit of A is the number of atoms decay per second, or in becquerel. The negative sign shows that the number of radioactive atoms is decreasing. The lambda in the formula is the decay constant that is defined as the probability of a radioactive atom to decay in 1 second. If you rearrange the formula and check back the definition of each of the term here, the number of atoms which decay per second divided by the number of radioactive atoms in the sample, recall the formula that probability Pa equal to Na over Ns, they are similar. We move on with the formula derivations. From the given formula dN dt equal to negative lambda n, we set the initial condition here as n naught equal to t equal to 0 second. Here we can rearrange the formula and perform integration. You should be able to get the equation n equal to n naught e to the power of negative lambda t. Next, we shall discuss about half-life. It is defined as the time required for the number of radioactive atoms to reduce to half of its original number. The boundary condition is that n equal to half n naught when the time is at half-life. We will substitute these values into the previous equation and simplify it. We can obtain the equation lambda equal to ln 2 divided by half-life. Now, we are going to derive a few more formulas. I think there's one formula you can remember, that the total time t can be expressed as multiple of half-life. Here, we can put the formula into the equation of n, and based on the formula of decay constant, we can obtain another formula where n equal to half to the power of x and naught, where x is the number of half-life. Besides this formula, we should also derive two more formulas for activity. From the formula of n equal to n naught e to the power of negative lambda t, we can obtain also similar equations that a equal to n naught e to the power of negative lambda t. Another is from the equation n equal to half to the power of x and naught, we can obtain a equal to half to the power of x a naught. I guess the derivation should be not too complex for you, just take some time to practice it. Here are the summary of the formula that involved in a radioactive decay. First line is given from the definition. Second line is directly related to the decay constant and the time of decaying. The last line is where we get the number of half-life, which I would say it is a simpler version of the equation in the second line. Let's discuss a few questions. First is from the SMKTT in year 2020. We will look at question C. Living plants have a constant percentage of C14 in the total amount of carbon in them. This C14 decays at the rate of 255 pq for every kg of carbon. So this value is constant as long as the plant is living. Once the plant is dead, the C14 decreases would decay with a half-life of 5,730 years as described in question B. A certain archaeology specimen of plant's origin was found to have a C14 activity of 50.3 pq per kilogram. Estimate the age of this archaeological specimen. So we can apply either the second or the third line equation as in the summary. Let's try both methods. First is that we need the information of the decay constant, which is ln 2 divided by half-life. Then we apply the formula, the age is approximately 13,400 years old. For the second method, we apply the formula and we can get the number of half-life is 2.34, and then we can multiply the half-life and we can get approximately the same answer as the first method. So I think you can try to play with both formulas when solving the related question in this topic. We move on to a question from SMK King George in 2021. A doctor used 1.49 microgram of iodine-131 to treat thyroid disorder, and it has half-life of 8 days. We need to find out the initial number of iodine atom. Here, we need to know how to get it from the mass and the molecular mass given. The number of atom is equal to the mass divided by molecular mass, which gives you the number of mole. Then multiply the Avogadro number to get the number of atoms. The answer here is 6.85 times 10 to the power of 15 atoms. Next is the initial activity. Apply the formula from the definition that A naught equal to lambda N naught, and also the formula of decay constant. The answer is 6.87 times 10 to the power of 9 BQ. Next is from Past Year in 2017. Here is the graph of ln A against T. Let us try to derive the equation of the graph. Since this is about A against T, we can start from the formula of A equal to A naught e to the power of negative lambda T. Apply ln on both sides, we can get ln A equal to negative lambda T plus ln A naught. From the linear law y equal to mx plus c, the gradient of the graph gives you the value of the decay constant, which is equal to negative 1. Put into the equation of decay constant, we can get the half-life is 0.69 seconds. Next is the y-intercept, which is equal to ln A naught. We have the equation A naught equal to lambda A naught. We can get the initial number of nuclei here is 1.07 times 10 to the 13 atoms. We shall discuss one last question which involves about the ratio or the relationship between variables. Here we are given with radioisotope X, which has 5 times activity higher than Y and also 4 times more of the number of mole. From the question you came George just now, we can see that the number of nuclei is proportional to the number of mole. So based on the condition of these two isotopes, you can build two equations first, then apply simultaneous that the first equation is divided by the second one. Put in the values, we can obtain the ratio is 4 to 5. In conclusion, the activity is proportional to the number of mole and inversely proportional to the half-life. You just need to be clear with those symbols and formula. This topic should be not a problem, and that is the last topic of STPM physics for this semester. So that's all for my discussion today. If you still have any question, leave it in the comment section below. Thank you.